especially, there is a lot of fighting, mostly because there is not a lot of police presence. But oftentimes it involves more than bows and arrows. It involves automatic weapons.
Oh.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh.
Yeah, that's it's not a good feeling when you're around that. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry. There is an education system, but it's a system of like a lot of British places where you have to, the school is not paid for by the government, you have to come up with school fees. And education is highly stratified. So if you want to go on after third grade, you gotta take a test, and then very few people make it to high school. So a lot of people have basic numeracy and they can sort of do some reading and writing, but most people don't have a chance to go get a full education. You guys have no idea. You guys have no idea what it's like. You guys can meet every day. You never have to worry about. You can drink the water out of your shower. That's how good the water supply system is in the United States. You have no idea. So yeah, education is a struggle for a lot of people there. But there are many educated Papua New Guineans as well. Yeah.
What type of government do they have?
They have a unicameral parliament following the Westminster system. So they have a prime minister and a parliament.
Oh, really?
Yes. Oh, no, you asked two questions already. Yeah.
What is their original religion that they like worship in Papua? And then if Christianity was brought to Papua New Guinea, when did that happen?
Well, it depends on where. But in the highlands where your water comes from, Western Highlands Province, Christianity arrived in like 1934. There was a single missionary called Father Ross who was Catholic. And there's still a large Catholic presence outside the Mount Hawken area. So they didn't really necessarily have like religion. You know, religion is this category that we kind of have invented. They had lots of different beliefs about spirituality. The country is huge, so it's quite a big deal. And there's also a long history of buying and selling religious cults and religious practices. So people would start doing something for a while, and then they'd hear about this other thing they could do, and then they'd sign up for that. So it's not like the place never changed. It was always in transformation. So in the area where I worked, it was 1963 that the first missionaries arrived. And they were sort of the latest in a series of religious movements that had kind of swept through the area. Yeah. Yes?
What's like the average salary for a normal person?
Well, most people in Papua New Guinea are unemployed farmers who grow their own food.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so, I knew people who would live on, like, 70 kina, which would be, like, maybe 20 bucks a year.
Whoa!
Yeah, so those people would buy, like, they needed money to buy cooking oil, salt, and then new machetes.
Wow.
That's pretty much what they needed for. And then there's other people who work on the coast who make decent money.
So you must make a lot of money.
You guys are starting to move. I feel like I should give you another activity. Or do you have more questions? Yeah.
I'm intervening with a mention of the secession from one of the islands.
Bougainville. Yes. Yeah, that's right. There's a great movie you guys should watch called Mr. Pip, which is all about the Bougainville Rebellion. There is a large copper mine there. They didn't want the copper mine there. They started exploding power pylons. There was a civil war. And then the government decided to send the island back to the Stone Age. They set up a perimeter around the island so no mill or other things could get in. And that lasted for about 20 years. And now the government on Bougainville is an autonomous government. They're trying to decide what their future is inside of Papua New Guinea. We actually have a friend of mine is coming next week, or 2 weeks from now, who's from Bougainville, who's an anthropologist who studies Bougainville. He's from Bougainville. Mm. Can I maybe just suggest one more thing? They have iPads? You guys have iPads?
Yeah.
I want to show you one more thing, because I had to ask somebody in Papua New Guinea to get it. Can we get them a copy of that file, the magazine, the fashion magazine?
Yeah.
I want you guys to maybe finish this, and then maybe for homework, if they have a reflection on the differences between what they see today. Yeah. So pull up your iPads. Yeah, I think if they could all read
it. Hold up those iPads.